Puck drops under Ryan Selwood. We'll chase that behind the net. We're back for the third period. The ENL Blaze looking to get back into the game now after Tom Pease's rocket has made it 2-1. And they've got the crowd behind them. Shot from Selwood, which Flavelle has to hold on to. We've just spoken to Paul Thompson in the second intermission, Chris. He's saying that the Blaze need to go to their top players, their stud players, as he referred to them. Do you agree with him?
I definitely agree with him. In a game like this, you cannot really afford to be giving juniors and lower order players the ice time. You've got to rely on your big guns until it's all said and done.
I'm surprised there was no whistle from Blaine Evans. That puck looked out to me, but it's behind the net. Play almost seems to stop as the Warriors look for it there. McWilliams, leg guard, behind the net. Blaze crowd try and cheer their team on as they attack early in the second period. Here is McWilliams, holds off the attentions of Dan Harris, who is showing no ill effects from his injury in the second period. Leggard pats that one out the air. Reynolds dumped in. Kravaka will collect the puck behind the net, and he will play it wide to Ross Venus. Paul Thompson saying the ENL Blaze need to hit Ross Venus. He's trying to shot from Leggard, and it nearly squirts out in front of the net. A Whitley stick gets to it first. As I was saying there, Chris, Paul Thompson saying that the ENL Blaze need to hit Ross Venus in stride because he's the best skater out there. We'll see if they manage to do so. Shot saved by Flavelle.
And Ross Venus there taking Blaine Evans out almost as well.
He is. It is. Times like this you forget Ross Venus is only 16.
I think that's the first time I've ever seen him throw a hit, actually.
Nice feet from Stevenson as he tries to get things going. Doesn't manage to, though. Nice hands. Stevenson, though. Nicklin nearly pulls that one in. The puck dribbles just out of reach, though.
Again, the bounce of the puck just defeating the Blaze. It just seems to be the one thing they can't get over, and it's something you really can't control.
Daniel Good now. My nomination for man of the match for Whitley so far. Tries to square it. Doesn't manage to. Tom Pease loses the puck. And Nichols helps him out as
Tom Pease almost went from hero to zero there.
Thankfully for the ENL Blaze, though, he didn't. And that will be icing. Brynjarski is quick, but there's no way he's getting to that. No. So, 2:16 gone in the third and final period. Still 2-1, but all the play so far in this third period has been at Whitley's end.
Still got another three and a bit periods to go of this game up in Whitley. But ENL Blaze there were riding the wave of momentum coming into this period, but it just seems to have stalled a little bit for now.
Here they come, though. James Pease, his brother Tom, scoring the goal that has brought the ENL Blaze back into this game. Brooks squirts up and off the netting, though, so there will be a face-off just outside the Blaze zone. Pollock loses the face-off. He will chase down Daniel Harris, though.
That
Harris
is really something that has let the Blaze down today, is their face-off percentage. They really need to start winning them.
Good save, Josh Nichols, from a speculative effort from Dan Harris outside the zone. Pollock pulls the puck in from behind him. This one's known as a hospital pass, but Pollock survives that one. Owen. Pollock fires one wide, spins one round, and can't really direct his shot. That's well kept in, Gareth Owen. And he's still got it.
That was a good recovery by Philip Pollock. If you can't get the pass off, at least keep it in the zone.
Gareth Owen puts a hit in on Peter Zajac. He's tripped, gets to his feet, still manages to play the puck into the zone, though. Gareth Owen looks extremely motivated, shall we say, for the third period. Paps, chased by Ryder. Paps will just play that one round the boards. Very nearly a bad pass. That's offside, though, for Whitley. And thankfully, because that was Windridge, I think, who nearly managed to find his way through.
And Tom Pease and Aidan Mahmood now having a conversation with Blaine Evans over by the bench.
That's interesting. We'll see what that one's about. I'd imagine they're just exchanging recipes, because I've never known hockey players have a word with a referee from the bench. Ever. He said, turning off the sarcasm again, because Chris is looking at me a bit unimpressed. Face-off to James Tavell's left. 3:35 gone in the third and final period.
Now it's his right.
They are. Blaine Evans is changing his mind. And once again, it's back to the point, and the shot comes in from the point, and McWilliams nearly tips that one past Lavelle.
And we have a broken stick on the ice. Don't know whose that is.
It's Reynolds, I think. He's collected one from the bench now, Adam Reynolds. And we haven't seen much of him so far. Adam Reynolds, we picked him out as the key player.
League's leading scorer has been a very quiet man. I think the most memorable, well, two most memorable moments we've had of him all night. The crease crash, and now DJ Good bringing it in.
And he'll try and get a shot off DJ Good. Good save, Josh Nichols at the near post. And he's helped out by his defence. Another shot is blocked as Good tries to inspire his team and restore with this two-goal lead. Shot across. Nichols isn't sure where that is, but Selwood is. Collects it. Now goes on a rush from the blue line. That's a knee. I thought someone left a knee in then.
And the home crowd unimpressed with that, and I am not very impressed either. That could have been very nasty.
Well,
for Ryan Selwood.
Indeed, no penalty call from Blaine Evans. Looked to me as well like Zajac left a knee in. Venus. Stevenson. And Venus will battle in the corner with two Whitley players. Stevenson tries to fight his way out. Doesn't manage to get to the puck though, and it's played off the boards. Tom Pease dumps it back in.
And we've had knee on knees before between these two teams, don't forget.
We have. They are arguably the most dangerous hits in hockey. Get them slightly wrong, and it's a broken leg for someone. Physical play going up a bit more. James Pease gets across, checking the back. That's a brave man right there, Adam Robinson. Robinson battling with Binyarski. Doesn't get to it. Robinson eventually uses his body to force Binyarski out of contention for the puck and lets a teammate play it. It's the back behind Blaze net. Tom Pease. Kipping. Shoves Pease into the boards, and now Robinson shoots. Good save by Josh Nichols.
Why Tom Pease didn't just belt that round the board, I don't know.
Yeah, got away with that one a bit. Whitley unimpressed that Adam Robinson was unceremoniously removed from the crease by, I believe, James Pease. 5:45 gone in this third and final period. And all the way through Ryder, but Nichols covers that one up and gives Ryder the 1,000-yard stare, Josh Nichols. He looks unimpressed with Nathan Ryder there.
It's good to see, though, in this period that the Blaze defense, even though they are allowing these mistakes to generate opportunities for the Warriors, when there's a rebound, there's always a Blaze stick that seems to get onto the end of it and clear it.
Indeed, they are protecting their goalie well so far this period. Nichols has to cover that. It sneaks in. How did that one sneak through? Robinson celebrating. I think that one snuck through Josh Nichols at the near post, judging by his reaction. A centering pass hits Nichols on the pad and goes into the net, and now you see the ENL Blaze players all skating over to have a word with Josh Nichols.
And the mountain for the ENL Blaze to climb just gets higher and higher, and as Paul Thompson said, go to the studs, and the studs are out because it's McWilliams, Ledgard, Venus, Kovacka and Selwood.
Nathan Ryder scoring unassisted at 46:06 for the Whitley Warriors. It looked like it was a centering pass that may have just hit Josh Nichols on the pad and deflected him. But Williams winds one up. It padded out in front, but finds a Whitley Warrior. Flavel will be very thankful for that, because he padded that one straight back out into the slot. And as you said, Chris, as you've been saying all game, Flavel is giving up rebounds. That's superb play, McWilliams. Back post, Flavelle has to cover it up. I'm not entirely sure what's going on behind the net.
Thornton and Venus having some kind of a discussion. Possibly that was holding there. It was definitely impeding Rossi's ability to get back up.
Indeed. It was a curious non-call by Blaine Evans. Venus was down on his knees for a good 15 seconds or so. Obviously, in the opinion of Blaine Evans, he wasn't making enough of an effort to get back up, perhaps looking for the penalty. Leg guard. Fights his way through. You can hear the Blaze crowd exhorting their team. Another stick goes up into the face of Adam Reynolds, I think. It is Adam Reynolds.
Well, it'll be interesting to see how this gets called, because Reynolds did go down practically hooking Tom Ledgard.
We'll see if Blaine Evans calls anything. It looks like he's decided 6-1, half a dozen.
Well, that is the smart decision there.
Reynolds, none the worse for wear. Just a slight blooded lip.
Reynolds may have took a high stick, but he was, let's face it, it was almost, practically was hooking there.
So now Stevenson will win that. James Pease, Kippen, finds Watson, already with two goals tonight. Callum Watson at the point, tries to find DJ Good, doesn't manage to. Blaze can come the other way though. 3-on-3. Whitley back checking at speed. Nicklin waits in front of the net. Shoved hard into the boards. There's a call. Kippen is surprised for that one, but that is a nasty check from behind on Ricky Binyarski. Binyarski is down on one knee. Looks all right.
Ricky's a tough nut. He can take it.
Kevin Bukas, the offending Whitley Warrior.
But Bukas will get... Is it going to be 2 minutes or is it going to be longer? We're waiting for the clock to go up. It will be 2 minutes. I'd assume for boarding. So checking from behind, I believe, is a major penalty, which would have been longer.
Indeed, we'll wait for the announcement for that one. It wouldn't surprise me if it was boarding, though. Binyarski, 7 feet away from the boards. It is boarding for Bukas. Kavaka winds one up, shoots it, hits Flavelle on the blocker and rebounds. Now, good pass from Pease to Kavaka. He will dump that one in for McWilliams to chase. Here is Reece McWilliams over in the corner. Eventually, digs it back out to Kavaka at the point. Kavaka dumps it back in. Gareth Owen, supported by Ledgard. Owen tries to get a shot off, doesn't manage to. Kavaka won't be able to keep that one in.
Realistically, that was a bit of an impossible angle, I think, for Gareth to try and shoot from there.
Blaze fans try to rally their team already. 50 seconds gone on this power play. Here now is, again, McWilliams in the corner. Fights his way out of the corner. Puck is clear. Watson will try and find Good. That's good interception. That's a superb interception, in fact, by Kieran Papps. Now crashing the net. Ledgard in space. Ledgard shoots. And it hits Flavelle.
And again, no Blaze players on the end of the rebounds as they come out.
I don't think Flavelle knew much about that one. I think he just threw himself in the direction of Ledgard and hoped. That was a gilt-edged chance.
But that was a wonderful setup there by Reece McWilliams.
Indeed, a fine
and good
pass.
Work by Kieran Papps, sneaking in the centre, taking Reece McWilliams' place on the rotation.
Venus now behind the net. 20 seconds remaining on this power play. Venus shoots. Flavelle lets him on free. It's still round the back of the net. And Stevenson can't get to that one. Blaze fans want a penalty call. They don't get one. Stevenson collides with the defenceman as he goes to collect his stick.
So that's holding the stick and possible interference missed there at the other end.
You tell me not to criticise the referees. Windridge puts one just wide, meanwhile. Whitley are back to full strength. Somewhat luckily for them. If you believe Chris, that's nice hands off Venus. But he can't beat Windridge, I think it was. Cully lurks. And Cully will go and collect that one. and just dump that one in. Nichols plays it for Pease. Pease controls it. Over in the boards, Venus now. Two players who've also played elitely together, combining. Nearly sticks through off the post. Nichols has to slide across. And I think that was Adam Reynolds missing a gilt-edged chance. He's got it back, though. Can't get the shot off. It's tense here. Nicklin now. Looks for support. Tries to find Philip Pollock. If my voice tends to fade in and out a bit over the rest of this game, it's because I'm feeling the tension almost as much as everybody else here. You could cut it with a knife. And this is only the first leg.
Well, it would appear that the stud plan hasn't really worked out, so Reg Wilcox has now resorted back to some of the young guns of the team.
That's a fine pass. Pollock pulls the pass in. Owen White heading for the net. Checked by two Whitley Warriors. Good play, Gareth Owen. Superb play, Gareth Owen. Nearly manages to kick one through. Hubbock will pick that one up and shoot. Pollock's flattened in front of the net. I think he was used as a shot blocker by the Whitley defenseman then. There's a stick lying free in the Whitley zone. Puck hits it. That's offside. Pollock is also tripped, but the whistle had already gone. So, 10 minutes remaining, Chris. What are the Blaze going to do to get back into this?
Well, I think they need to... they're doing one thing well, which is not responding to the antics of the Warriors that we're obviously seeing up here, that Blaine Evans isn't seeing. As we've said before, being a referee is a hard job. Other than that, they just need to keep pelting away at Favell, I think, because I think he's going to crack again soon.
He has faced more rubber than a dead cat on the M1, as Dave Sims likes to say. Lots of shots Favell's way, but he's stopped all but one so far. Whereas Josh Nichols has let three past him. Here's for Williams, though. Good play, Reece for Williams. Gets a shot off. It goes just wide. Rebounds. Leg guard shoots. Flavel drops and covers any gap that he may have left.
Definitely an answer to your question that you just asked me a second ago. What do they need to do? Net presence. Someone needs to be buzzing that net all the time. Somebody needs to be filling in for Reece McWilliams when he's doing like he just did there and moving the puck in.
Kavaka keeps the puck in, flicks it towards the net. It's free. Leg guard nearly tips one just wide. The pump dribbles agonisingly wide. Off a leg guard stick in front of the net. Now Good comes the other way. It's 2-on-1. Daniel Good wants to pass back. Doesn't get it, though. That's fine play by Kavaka. There's a whistle. The net has been knocked off. A Blaze defenseman colliding with Josh Nichols.
And James Flavell continues to make his exchanges at the Bank of Lady Luck.
Nice. With any luck, as we say... Is he using up all his luck allocated for this playoff final in the first leg? We will see tomorrow. Scorched Ice will, of course, be there. Chris and I are making the trip up to Whitley Blaze along with our Canberra team.
Rob, and Dave.
And we'll see what kind of situation we'll have. There's still 9 minutes remaining in this game, though. And at the moment, the score is 3-1 in favour of the Whitley Warriors. The ENL Blaze need to give themselves, in my opinion, another goal. A one-goal deficit is doable. A two-goal deficit. And with the fervent Whitley Warriors crowd behind them, you've got to back the Warriors to bring it home in the second leg. But here come the ENL Blaze with Nicklin. Nicklin shoots! Flavel just waves a glove at it. And it goes over the top.
And Nicklin showing with a clear bit of ice ahead of him what he can do.
It's across again. It's still free. Watson can't find the puck in his feet. Binyarski wants it. James Pease cruising forward like a pocket battleship down centre ice. But he doesn't manage to control the puck. Tom Pease now. James Pease now playing as a power forward, I think. In fact, Binyarski, no, he's now moved back to defence. Binyarski playing very well. He's hooked down. There's a call. Blaine Evans sees Binyarski's tripped. And the ENL Blaze will get another power play Whitley are giving us the chances here, Chris. They're certainly trying to make it interesting. It's Andrew Cook who goes to the penalty box for tripping.
Penalty for the Warriors.
12:42.
It's Cook Andrew.
I'm assuming that one's the wrong way round. Now, face-off won by Kavaka shoots. It's tipped in front by McWilliams, but unfortunately only into Flavelle's pad.
And those tip-ins from Reece McWilliams are deadly.
Seen him score several times this season that way, but here come Whitley the other way. Nice hand, shot saved, Nichols. It's still free.
Beautiful defensive work there by the ENL Blaze.
And now McWilliams at the offensive end for the Blaze will take it into the corner. He will try and find a teammate. Doesn't manage to, though. But will be dumped around the boards and collected by, eventually, Kieran Papps. Off a feed from Kavaka. Kavaka gets it back. 1:23 remaining on this power play for the ENL Blaze. Owen down the right-hand side. Takes it into the corner. Finds McWilliams. McWilliams digging away. Looking for support. Leg guard in front of the net. McWilliams goes for the wraparound. Flavelle has to cover that one up. 1:09, and they appear to have listened to you, Chris. They are getting people into James Flavelle's face at every opportunity, the ENL Blaze.
Well, Reg is obviously seeing what we're seeing up here, and he's making those changes just like any good coach should do. He's responding to the situation that's occurring out there for his players.
Now, Tom Pease, Blaze goalscorer, looks at the point, has to get the puck out from between his feet, finds Ross Venus. James Pease lurks over the far side, nearly snuck in. That's a fine improvisation there from Michael Stevenson, but unfortunately only finds the post. Tom Pease winds one up. That one nearly finds its way through. Stevenson digging away. Ross Venus shoved into the boards by Brummett. He goes down. Venus decides to stay on the puck. Plays it out eventually. Back to Tom Pease again at the point. Stevenson. Venus can't control it. Now Tom Pease. Playing well tonight, Tom Pease. Free, Nicklin, digs. Can't get a shot off, though. And eventually the puck is cleared down the ice. 20 seconds remaining on the power play.
And that's part of the problem here for the ENL Blaze. They just can't seem to find a way around the box out that the Whitley Warriors are applying in the defensive zone on the penalty kill.
10 seconds remaining on this power play. James Pease, like a battleship in full sail, through centre ice. He loses control of the puck, though, and it goes all the way back to Tom Pease, his brother, finds leg guard. Leg guard, Cully coming off the bench, could have played a hit there, didn't.
Too many men there.
Good play, leg guard digging away with Andy Thornton behind the goal. That's down the ice. 5 minutes remaining in this first leg now. That's icing though, so the puck will come all the way back down to James Flavelle's end, the open end of the Sky Dome to our right.
And as coach Orion said in Mighty Ducks 3, how long does it take to goal score a goal? Less than a second. And with 5 minutes remaining, you've got to believe that possibly the ENL Blaze can do it if they keep banging on the pressure the way they have done against Whitley so far in this period.
We should state the way the ENL Blaze have played so far this year. A one-goal loss to Whitley still leaves them with a chance because they are not unbeatable, the Warriors. As we said in the pre-game show, they lost 4-2 to Blackburn in the first leg of their playoff semi-final. Now, Owen will collect behind the net. Want some help? Pollock goes to pick up the puck. Plays it back around the boards. And Windridge will block that one. And a whistle from Blaine Evans. 4 minutes, 2 goals. Is it doable, Chris?
I think it's doable. If everything falls the way the ENL Blaze want it to fall, it's doable.
We're now waiting for a face-off to Josh Nichols' left. ENL Blaze have probably won as many as they've lost, but they need to win more against a team like Whitley. Leg guard shoots it free, and Venus can't get his swipe at the puck to connect as he comes in at great speed. Just mistimes his swipe. Selwood goes full length to keep that one in. Leg guard now with Venus. Finds it for the net. Score! by ENL Blaze. Richmond Williams in front of the net. And you beauty.
Well, he said to me the other night at training in reference to the Just Call Me the Trash Man comment he made. He scores most of the time from less than 5 feet out. And there you go. Reece McWilliams with a captain's goal, bringing the ENL Blaze back into it with 4 minutes just under remaining in this game. Can they tie it up to take it back to Whitley?
He's got a huge smile on his face. Grease Lightning rings out round the Sky Dome. But Williams drives one low into the bottom corner. And they're looking a little nervous on the Whitley bench. Reece McWilliams makes it 3-2.
Scored by number 86,
Nicklin now round the back of the net as the ENL Blaze look to get their equaliser. Here is Pinyarski. How we could do one of his missed shots there.
56-01.
Fine pass from Ross Venus to find McWilliams from the right boards.
All he had to do was just slot it below Flavel.
McWilliams says, thank you very much. Have that, Flavel. Into the bottom corner.
Now, yes, Mr. Faceoff, as I call him, Michael Stevenson, in, and he wins it.
Nice feet from Stevenson there. Gives the Blaze a chance once again. Nicklin.
And
Stevenson's been held down.
Again, Blaine Evans missing a holding call, next time by Harris on Stevenson.
Flavel drops on it. They're not sure where the puck is. It's still free. Harris having a shove. Flavel deciding just to stay down and cover the puck.
Keep calm, boys. Just play it cool. Don't rise and don't wind up putting yourselves in the box unnecessarily, because the momentum is all in your favour. The second you give in to these antics that the Warriors are pulling at the moment, things like that, just a little bit of holding on the ice, all it takes is one punch and we've got a guy in the box for 2 minutes.
But now, once again, the ENL Blaze putting Gareth Owen out along with Philip Pollock and Connor Hubbock on the forward line. Owen chasing Nathan Ryder, scorer of the third goal for the Whitley Warriors. After a centering pass from him, hit Josh Nichols and redirected, sadly, for the ENL Blaze into the bottom corner of Nichols' net. Big check in the corner by Aidan Mahmood. Still digging away. Tripped. Stevenson will fight that one out. Eventually, it's free. Adam Reynolds changes direction. Nichols has to slide across. He blocks it. Good save. Good awareness. Josh Nichols. He's doing his bit.
He's got Gareth Owen in the middle. He needs to pass to Owen.
And Hubbock eventually finds Owen. Possibly slightly later than Owen would have wanted. Selwood stepping up from defence. Takes the hit to play that one back in. Owen now. The ENL Blaze smell blood in the water. Can they get the equaliser? And leave it all square. Going up to Hillheads tomorrow. He's hauled down. That's cynical there behind the goal on Philip Pollock. Wrestled to the ice in a headlock by Ali Brummett, I think that was. We'll see who it is.
Brummett got up as if to say, what? What did I do? What did I do wrong? You had a player in a headlock and hauled him down. And I don't believe it. Evans is letting him get away with it.
Evans hasn't called it. He's obviously decided it was 6-1, half a dozen of the other. Which the ENL Blades are obviously unimpressed with.
I've decided to forego my policy of not having a go at the ref tonight, I think.
Kovacka just confirming with Blaine Evans why he didn't call that. But Williams, Venus, Leggard, Kovacka, Selwood for the ENL Blaze. Won by McWilliams, who heads straight for the net. Kovacka tries to feed him, doesn't manage to. But Williams just collides with Bukas. Three in front of the net. Venus digging away, doesn't get to it though. That's well played by Williams to cut that pass for Cully. If that pass had got through, Cully would have made it. 2 minutes remaining. 3-2 to the Whitley Warriors in this ENL North playoff final first leg. Selwood. And the Blaze crowd exhorting their team to one last effort. Venus can't find Kovacka. Puck's cleared. One thing I've noticed about James Favell, when the puck's behind the net, he does drop to his knees and he does stay down there for quite some time until after the pass has come out in front. He could be caught high.
I think he's now anticipating, because we've seen the Blaze try and do it so many times now. They're going for that Doug Gilmore-style wraparound attempt. And it isn't really working. Because Favell, like any good goaltender should, is anticipating that happening.
Stevenson wins the face-off. Nicklin plays it back to Tom Pease at the point. It's behind the net with Stevenson. Nicklin and Binyarski both waiting in front of the net. Favell has to hold on to that one. Binyarski tries to get a tip. Stares at Andrew Thornton. And they're waiting in front. We said before the game the ENL Blaze were after 500 people. They've got more than 500 people in the rink this evening. Roaring on the ENL Blaze. We're into the final minute nearly. 18:55 gone. Blaze trying to get the equaliser. Nicklin. Now Stevenson. Battling in the corner. Binyarski goes in to support him. Binyarski wins it. Hits Flavel's pad and goes behind the net. Standing strong in his near post, James Favell. Puck is cleared. Out to centre ice. We're into the final 45 seconds. Kippen intercepts.
Where was Reg Wilcox? Next stop in play, I would call a timeout.
We'll see if he does.
Don't think he's going to.
It looks like he's going to let the final 33 seconds of this game play out. 3-2 to the Whitley Warriors. Two goals from Callum Watson and one from Nathan Ryder for the Warriors. Reece McWilliams and Tom Pease scoring for the ENL Blaze. Selwood feeds Kavaka. Kavaka plays that long, no icing though, but Williams gets to it. Plays it round the back of the net. Kavaka chasing that puck in. We're into the final 15 seconds. Whitley just trying to hold the puck in the corner, but it worked its way out now. Free in front of the net. Oh, and Selwood. Unfortunately, the puck comes on the wrong side. If it came on his stick side, he might have got one off then. Kippen fires a shot. End of Act 1. It's 3-2 to the Whitley Warriors after the first leg. But this tie is still very much open, I think, Chris.
It is still all to play for. If the Blaze tomorrow can play the way they did in that period, I think it's still possibly all to play for. If the Blaze from the second period turn up, however, I think it may all be Whitley's.
We'll be up there tomorrow, covering the second leg of the playoff final. Just before we finish off the commentary, man of the matches, Chris. Man of the matches for the two teams.
Well, man of the match for ENL Blaze. It's a bit of a tricky one, this, for me. But I'm going to go with, I think Reece McWilliams deserves it.
Indeed.
Not just because of that one goal, that, although it did galvanise the team's efforts to push on. He's been solid all night long, moving that puck around and getting it into the zone, and he's been so unlucky. For Whitley, I went with him the last time, two times he was here, and I'm going to go for him again. James Flavell. He kept them in this tonight. He is the reason they are currently still 3-2 up. He made saves. He had no business making at times tonight.
Indeed, for me, they're good choices. I think Daniel Good also has a shout for the Whitley Warriors.
Oh, yes, definitely, obviously. And Callum Watson as well with his two goals. Definitely
very,
very, very strong performance. One player I'm very surprised we didn't hear too much of tonight, Reynolds.
Indeed.
He's very well neutralised by the ENL Blaze tonight.
They obviously realised he would be one of the most dangerous players, Adam Reynolds. We said he was a great player to watch. We didn't see that much of him. And now we go back up to Whitley, which is a hostile rink at the best of times. So
I've never been there, so I couldn't really comment on this.
It's definitely a rink at which the Warriors will more than have home advantage. And you can see it is Fortress Hillheads. So we'll be up there tomorrow. We hope you'll be watching us up there. And from me, Paul Wheeler and Chris Beal, goodbye at half time of the ENL playoff final.